Hello friends, this is Lahu Zadav welcomes you on behalf of IS Mind Maps Innovating IS Preparations. Friends, before we begin, please subscribe to our YouTube channel IS Mind Maps and don't forget to ring the bell for latest updates and notification. Friends, we are also on Facebook and Telegram. Friends, this is about me. I have graduated in Electronics Engineering, work with Infosys Limited and appear for interview in 2016. Secured 279 marks in sociology optional. Friends, in previous discussion, we have discussed one problem of population in India, that is aging population. In that we have discussed status of senior citizen in India. In that we have discussed that currently in India we are having 14.2% of population as a senior citizen out of total population of India, that is 125 crore. Then we have discussed problems of senior citizen and their causes, consequences of these problems, government initiatives taken and solution from IS Mind Maps. So friends, please visit our previous videos by clicking on this link. You can find this link in the description section also. Today's agenda will be migration in India. Then we are going to discuss various aspects of migration in India, status of migration, types of migration, causes of migration. Then we are going to discuss consequences of this and government initiatives taken and solution from IS Mind Maps. Friend, let us discuss one by one. Migration. Let us discuss what is mean by migration. Migration basically in itself is not a problem. But in India, migration has become a problem. We are going to discuss how it has become a problem. Because ideally, in Western countries, when a person moves from one place to like from rural area to urban area, then there is improvement in their lifestyle, in their income earning, so that overall development of an individual happens and indirectly the family. But in India it is happening in reverse way. It is a very complex phenomenon because everything is interrelated. When a rural person is migrating to urban area in India, then he is ending up in a slum area, as there are no accommodation and due to the expensive lifestyle in the urban area and other governance issues. So actually their condition is degrading rather than improving. So that's why in India migration has become a problem. So migration is basically moving from one place to another. It can be temporary and it can be permanent. Okay, friend. There is another concept like the migration. We often get confused in that. That is the refugees. Migration is mostly mostly driven by the will of the person who is getting migrated. But in case of refugees, there are external factors. We are going to discuss what are external factors for refugees. In that, it can be a climate change. So it is now an emerging problem that is known as a climate refugees. Another factor is the government policy, like in case of Rohingya refugees. So friend, major difference could be that in the case of protection, like for the refugees, that problem is governed by the United Nations Convention on Refugees. So every state should, those who have signed that convention, they should follow that guidelines or conventions. The central government or the government don't have much freedom in formulating the policies. But in case of migration, we are going to discuss in a detail. Migration and versus refugees. So as we have discussed now, migration is basically will-based. But the refugee concept is more about and it can be within a country also. Refugee can be within a country, that is intra-country and outside also. Means, suppose if there is any disaster or any terrorist activity, then if suppose a person is moving from Bihar UP to Maharashtra or Bihar UP to Delhi, then it is a refugee within a state or due to the communal riots. But if a person is moving from one country, like from Myanmar, the Rohingyas from this they have moved on to here India, again other countries, Bangladesh. So this is a outside the country, so inter-country refuge also can happen. So this is the basic difference between a migration and a refugees. Friends, let us now move on to next topic, that is types of migration. In types of migration, we are going to discuss two major types, that are the intra-country, that is a within a country, and the inter-country, between a country. So on this slide, we are going to discuss various types of intra-country migrations, that are rural to rural migration. Means moving from one village to another, like this. And the major cause of this, and in India, this is the largest type of migration. And the important reason is marriage. Because in India, rural population consists of around 66%. So that's why the people, after getting the marriage, the girl moves to the husband's place. So that's why this migration is the largest in India. And there are other regions also. Another aspect is rural to urban. This is basically more about economic migration, educational regions, etc. And again would be the caste system. We are going to discuss in detail in next slide. Economic could be the for the betterment of life, education for educational or graduation or other aspects, and caste system to, as the urban, in urban areas mostly the cities are anonymous, so caste system is not that relevant, but the class system is more relevant. So to escape that caste or untouchability in rural areas, the people are moving from rural area to urban area. Another type of migration within intra country is urban to urban. Urban to urban means moving from one city like Nagpur to Pune. So this is a urban to urban migration. This could be because of job or education, etc. Another type of migration is a urban to rural migration. This is a very, now it is a emerging migration. It is very predominant in the Western countries. Like after retirement, the senior citizens are getting moved to the rural areas due to the clean environment and other lack of pollution in rural areas. So this is the one of the reason. But in India, it is now an emerging problem. People are getting attracted toward the rural areas because of various reasons. And after earning in the urban areas, they are purchasing land and properties in rural areas and shifting to there. Like in Delhi and other places, there is a lot of pollution. So people are trying to avoid that. Another type of migration is interstate. Interstate means people are moving from one state to another, like from UP, Bihar, people are moving to New Delhi, Maharashtra, Chennai, etc. So this is an interstate migration between a state. This could be again because of economic reason, for betterment of life, and other aspect could be education. So in that, in economic also, the job or occupation is also predominant. And in one aspect is the people are also moving because of education, in that the preparation of the civil service is also one of the crucial example of the migration of the students. So that can be again come under the interstate from different states to the New Delhi. So now friends, after discussing types of problems within intra-country, now let us discuss another type of migration, that is inter-country. Inter-country means between two different countries. So inter-country India, people from this region, Kerala, they are actually the migration is basically happens at two level. One is a skill migration, another is a unskilled migration. A skill migration is from the India, it is moving to America and Europe. And non-skill or unskilled migration is happening from India to Middle East. The from the Kerala, the nurses are moving on to the Middle East. So this, that's why the Kerala is known as remittance economy. Now the emerging trend is like people from India are moving to Southeast Asia, again to China and Central Asia. These are the emerging trend. So friends, this is a inter-country migration, and people work there and they send the remittances to their families in the India. So this is again contributing to the overall economic development of our nation. But again, the problems are associated with it. We are going to discuss it in a consequences of migration. So friend, let us move on to next topic, that is causes of migration. So after discussing till now, there can be different reasons for migration, for the within a country, that is intra migration and inter migration, that is from India to other countries. Again, in that there are various regions within an inter country also, for the rural to rural, as we have seen. So friends, let us discuss common causes of migration in India. There are different causes at the push, what are the push factor and pull factor. So what are the push factor we are going to discuss, like what are the causes at the source level. If suppose a person is moving from UP, Bihar to Delhi, or Maharashtra to Delhi, or people from Maharashtra moving to Bangalore, then this is known as source and this is known as destination. So what are the push factor at the source level and what are the pull factor at the destination level, we are going to discuss. In push factor, one of the aspect is a social aspect. A social aspect means what are the social regions for the migrations at the source level. One aspect is a caste system. To avoid the rigidity of caste system and the associated negative externalities, people are moving from rural area to urban area, because in urban area there is anonymity, so no one knows other people caste. So this is one of the aspect, this is one of the reason in social aspect. Second aspect is social status, for better economic life. After, if someone is working in urban area, then it is considered good. So it is our perception of a job in our Indian society. So this is also one of the aspect. Friends, those are the few reasons for social reasons at the push level. Okay. Next topic is economic reasons. So economic reason could be the betterment of life, that is more earning more income. Another is entertainment. So these are the reasons. Second is a political reasons. Due to the politics of the region also, people move from one area to another. Like in case of rural to urban migration, due to the political affiliations of a particular region, people are moving from one region to another. Another is a disasters. Friends, due to disaster also, people are migrating from one place to another, like communal riots in Muzaffarnagar, people have migrated to other places. Again, the atrocities among the northeastern people, the people from Bangalore and Chennai, they have migrated to their original places or to other safe places like Maharashtra. So this is also one of the reason. Again, people from the Chennai flood, etc., they are also getting migrated to other places, from the Uttarakhand region to the lower New Delhi, Haryana, etc. Friend, terrorism is also one of the aspect for the migration, like from the Middle East region like Sudan, etc., people are moving to the Europe. So Sudan to Europe, that is inter-country migration. ISIS, etc., because of that the people are moving from Africa to Europe. Again, internal conflict is also one of the reason. The African continent is the best example. The internal conflict between different tribes, etc., is happening, and because of that the internally, again there is one concept like internally displaced people. So they are within a country but they are displaced, like, but they are not known as a refugees, because refugees are the persons who are moving from one place to one country to another. So that's why they are known as internally displaced people. another reason is a climate change. Climate change also one of the factor for the migration. Like and best example is Rohingya crisis. Rohingya crisis is one of the aspect. Again, this is and is also example of the internal conflicts. Okay. Now let us discuss what are the pull factors. In pull factors also there are social reasons, the various facilities are this available in the urban areas. This is also one of the aspects. Another is the economic, in that the better opportunities available in the urban areas, better wages. Third aspect is the security. The urban areas like Pune or etc. and other New Delhi is not so secure for the women. So based on the pull factor also responsible for the migration. Based on that people decides whether should you go there or not. So this, that's why security is also very crucial. Again, the pull factor is the climate. Climate, how the climate can act as a pull factor, because if like in Delhi there is lot of pollution, so people will think twice before going to Delhi or migrating unless and until it is very urgent to move there. So that's why climate is also playing very crucial factor for the migrations. Friend, now let us discuss what are the consequences of migration in India. Consequences could be at a source site and at the destination site, as we have discussed. So suppose if someone is moving from a place like if we are to Delhi and from Maharashtra to Delhi, so in that or Maharashtra to Chennai, so this is the source area and this is the destination area. So now let us discuss what are the consequences of migration at source and destination. In that we are going to discuss what are the positive consequences and what are the negative. So at source site, change in the population composition. That means generally the migration happens in the male. So male generally get migrated from one place to another. So there is a change in composition of population at the source site. That is, there will be more female per male. That is change in the sex ratio. Again, feminization of agriculture. If the male member are getting migrated from the rural area to the urban area, then only the female remains in the rural area. So that is the reason, one of the reason for feminization of agriculture. Another aspect, and that is actually empowerment of a woman, because they are getting authority and they are getting the control of the resources, remittances. If someone is migrating from India to some other country, they are sending the remittances to their families in the India. Another positive factor or consequence could be availability of technology from the destination. Suppose if someone is moving from India to United States, so they can have a latest technology from the destination and various other facilities available to the source nation. Then let us discuss what are the negatives at the source site. Negatives could be separate families. After the concept of separate family is like after getting married, the husband is living in Pune and the wife is living in some other place like Bangalore. So this is known as a separate family. They are not getting divorced. They are not divorced, but due to the occupation, they have to live separate. This is one of the aspect, and this again having consequences on the family life. Another aspect, inadequate human resource at the source level. Suppose if people are getting moved from Bihar to UP, Bihar and UP to Delhi and to the Maharashtra, then there is inadequate human resource in this place. So this is consequences, positive and negative consequences at the source site. Now friends, let us discuss what are the positive and negative consequences at the destination site. So the positive could be the adequate human resource. Suppose if someone is moving from Maharashtra to Bangalore, then there will be adequate resources in the Bangalore. So this is positive because the labor force will be available at a cheap cost. So overall for the economic development of the Bangalore or Karnataka, it will be beneficial. Another aspect is the Indian diaspora. Suppose if someone is moving from India to other countries, then the presence of Indian diaspora is getting increased in that area. Suppose in the United States, if Indians are moving to United States, then they are playing very crucial role in the policy formulation, in foreign policy formulation, like it happens during the 2005 nuclear deal. So it's a very crucial, and that's why it's a positive aspect. And again is a economic growth, the economic growth of the destination. Suppose if someone is moving from this region UP Bihar to Maharashtra or New Delhi, then there is a economic development of New Delhi at the destination place or Maharashtra. And if someone is moving from India to other countries, then the destination nation is getting benefited from it, like United States and UK. Then friends, now let us discuss what are the negative aspect of at the destination side. Change in population composition. As recently we have discussed that mostly the male get migrated, so there is a change in the sex ratio at the destination side. So the female to male composition, that is, there will be less female per male in the urban area. Another aspect, emergence of slum. If someone is moving from rural area to urban area, then there is a slum pop, there will be increase in a slum in the urban areas, as there are lack of accommodation in the urban areas. Another aspect is a negative aspect is a exploitation. Friends, as the people who are getting, especially the unskilled workers, if they are moving from rural to urban area, then there are chances that they are getting exploited because they are illiterate and they are not aware of their rights. So this is also one of the negative aspect of migration. Another aspect is a internal security challenges. People are migrated from the Bangladesh to the Assam and to the West Bengal. So this has created a lot of internal security challenges, as we have seen. So these are the negative of at the destination side of the migration. So friends, if you have any doubts regarding this, if you are getting clear it, please let us know in the description section. We are going to clarify that at the same place. Now friends, now let us discuss what are the government initiatives taken. In government initiative, we are going to divide this in a IS mind maps way, as a direct efforts and indirect efforts. One policy was there, like Pura, providing urban facilities in rural area. This is the concept of Pura given by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. This is like providing the urban facilities in rural area itself, so that the people will not get migrated from rural area to the urban area. Another scheme launched last year in 2016 was Rural Urban Scheme. In that, there was a concept of cluster of villages are getting developed, and this is based on a system approach and regional planning approach. Again, there was one effort was Slum Rehabilitation Scheme. It was launched by different states in different proportion. So every state having their own slum rehabilitation schemes. This is a scheme at the destination level. Like if people are getting migrated from rural area to urban area, then there should be a proper slum rehabilitation scheme. Another direct effort could be the smart city program, to make the cities or urban area more capable to adjust to the growing size of the urban area. Another direct effort was the MNREGA, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. In that, it is for the source area, so that providing the employment to the people at the rural area itself, so that they should not come to the urban area. Another direct effort was the Bharat Nirman. It is also providing the facilities like construction of road, providing electricity, etc. Another scheme was Ustad scheme. This scheme more focus on the preserving and enhancing the traditional skills of the minorities. So friends, now let us discuss what are the indirect efforts, because in society nothing happens in isolation, so everything is interrelated. So then what are the indirect efforts taken by the government of India? First one could be the Pravasi Bharati Divas, that is celebration of Pravasi Bharati Divas. That means we are celebrating the people who have migrated to the other countries, NRIs, etc. Another efforts was Skill India, providing skills to the unskilled people. That is very crucial for the overall economic growth of our nation. If the person is more skilled, then there will be less chance of getting exploited, and he will going to get more wages as per his skill. Another scheme is Make in India. This is focus on the manufacturing sector, so that people, if they are coming to the urban area, so they should get the more opportunities of job. Startup India is basically improving new avenues and improving the efficiencies and opening up new employments for the people who are coming to urban areas. And there are again the talk about Startup India and Stand Up India in the rural area also. So Stand Up India is basically for the overall empowerment of the woman. Woman SC and weaker section, woman SC and SC, ST. Startup India Entrepreneurship Scheme. Again, there was scheme of Mudra Yojana. It is also for the empowerment of the micro and small industries. So friends, with this direct and indirect efforts, Government of India also providing various impetus to improve the lifestyle of the migrated people. Now let us discuss solution from the IS mind maps. Friends, this could be done at different levels. One is at the government side and another is at the societal side. So friends, at the government side, firstly we have to decide that migration change in the attitude of the government, because migration in itself is not a problem. So migration is a good for a country, because recently economic survey has mentioned that there are 9 million people who are getting migrated every year. Last year economic survey have mentioned about it. Creation of magnet cities. Magnet cities means, this is a concept, like suppose this is a Delhi. If people are getting migrated from UP, Bihar and from Maharashtra, then they should not go directly to Delhi. So in between, we should again create another cities, like in Rajasthan few cities, in Madhya Pradesh few cities, so that people will get like in Nagpur also, people should get attracted toward those cities, and these cities will going to act as a magnet, so that people will directly will not go to the New Delhi, because that will going to add more pressure on the New Delhi, and there will be again governance issues, security issues, etc. So this is the concept of magnet cities. So friends, if you want further discussion on this, please let us know in the description section. Another aspect could be providing better governance. So better governance, for that Government of India taking various initiatives, and we are moving from governance to good governance, and various schemes have been launched like smart cities to improve the governance of a urban area. And again, removing or reducing the corruption in the various government schemes at the implementation level, that is very crucial for the solving the various problems of migrations. Another step could be taken at the societal level, like in the inculcation of various values like tolerance, love, etc., so that there will not be any communal violence or conflict between the local people and the migrated people, like it happens in Maharashtra. So that should be avoided, as the migration, because Article 19 give rights to everyone to move within a country. So it is a fundamental right of every citizen to move within India freely. Another societal initiative could be the community cooperation. So community cooperation should be promoted. Caste rigidity should decrease. And as it is a birth based caste system, so it should not have that much place in our new modern lifestyle. Another aspect could be the change in the attitude of the citizens or society toward the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. So that is also related to the migration. Suppose if you are have a clean area or a clean region, people are getting attracted toward it, people want to get migrated to that area. Like the western countries, people are more attracted, like everything is in place, everything is clean. So we as an Indian, we should change our behavior, we should change our attitude toward the Swachh Bharat Mission, and we should accept and adopt the Swachh Bharat Mission as a society. Another aspect could be done at the private level. At private level, the CSR can be used in the migration to decrease the various negative aspect of the migration. Again, the efficiency and their experience could be brought, technology, etc., to solve the various problems of the migration. Friends, after discussing the solution from IS mind maps, now our next topic will be going to continue the problems of Indian society. We are going to discuss another related associated issues. So friends, thank you very much for listening IS mind maps. See you soon.